This is Mother O. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. This is Church on the Hill, making you brighter, better, and bigger. Today, Apostle is continuing with his message, The Just Shall Live by Faith. What a relevant time to speak on the message of faith. You know, during this COVID-19, you know, we are experiencing, you know, economic meltdown, and, you know, we are threatened in terms of health. But David says, I would have lost heart unless I believed that I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. This is the time when you should believe that whatever happens around you economically, you will not lose your job. You will not lose your business. And your children also, you and your family will not catch the COVID-19. You need to believe God. You need this message on faith. The just shall live by faith. Faith comes by hearing and hearing and hearing and hearing and hearing the word of God. So as the message is brought to you and you feel like you have heard it, you need to hear it and hear it, for it to sink into your spirit, and then you do by the spirit, you speak by the spirit, for you to be able to experience results. I want also to encourage you that you not only be a hearer of the word, but you must go further, be a doer of the word. The word that you have received concerning your financial breakthroughs, the word that you have received over a period of time concerning tithing, concerning giving, this is the right time for you to do the word of the Lord for the fulfillment of God's promises. He will rebuke the devourer, even COVID-19, for your sakes. And you'll open wide the windows of heaven, you know, flooding you with opportunities that are not, you know, are not naturally, you know, given to you, or you will not be able to naturally receive those opportunities because of the COVID-19. God will make sure that you receive your own breakthroughs, your own miracles, your own blessings amidst the situation that you are facing. I want us right now to give, use the details below there. Let us receive Apostle MVG Lepoko right now into our hearts and into our homes as he brings the third part of the just shall live by faith. Like us, share, comment, and also subscribe.
This is Apostle MVG Lepoko greeting you in the name of Jesus, making you brighter, better, and bigger. This is part three of our message, The Just Shall Live by Faith. The just shall live by faith. We established in part one and part two of this message that faith is compulsory for us as believers in our relationship with God. And the reason why faith is important, it is because we connect to God by faith. You connect to God by faith, but also you connect to the devil by fear. So later in this series, I will talk to you on faith vis-a-vis fear. The just shall live by faith. Ephesians 2 verse 8. The Bible says, for by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast. So our relationship with God began by faith. If your relationship with God started by faith, then it has to continue by faith. The Apostle Paul in Romans 1 verse 17 says, for in it the righteousness of God is revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by faith. We move from faith to faith. We start our relationship with God by faith. We continue our relationship with God by faith. Anything that you do for God without faith or outside of faith is futile. Hear me. Anything that you try to do for God without faith or outside of faith, it becomes futile. It is very interesting to note that as human beings, we do too many things to try and impress God, except for faith. Human beings like to impress, and God is one of the many people that we want to impress, or we like to impress through our prayers, our worship, our giving, our serving, and many other things that we do to impress God. But I want you to understand today that anything that you do for God without faith, it does not work. It does not serve the purpose. Whatever you say or do, you must do it in faith. You must say it in faith. Without faith, there is no way you can please God. Hear me, child of God. You must not do anything for God under pressure, out of fear, or to impress Him. Let me say this again. Don't do anything for God under pressure, out of fear, or trying to impress God. God always checks the motive behind anything that you do for Him. Only our faith pleases God. Meaning we must pray by faith, we must worship by faith, we must give by faith, we must serve by faith. It is faith, faith, and faith all the way. Faith in season and faith out of season. Faith when everything is going for you and faith when everything is going against you. Faith all the way. So I want us to go back to our scripture, Hebrews 11, verse 1, that gives us the definition of faith. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Here we are talking about the God kind of faith, and the God kind of faith is built or established on the word of God. Remember that God and His word are one. If you read John chapter number 1, from verse number 1, the Bible says, in the beginning was the word. The word was with God, and the word was God. So the Bible tells us that God and His word are one. Hear me, child of God. When we talk about the God kind of faith, we mean the faith that is built on the word of God. So Hebrews 11 verse 1, it says the faith that is built on the word of God is the one that is defined in this verse. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Let's read it in the Amplified version of the Bible. It says, now faith is the assurance, tightly deed, confirmation of things hoped for, divinely guaranteed, and the evidence of things not seen, the conviction of their reality. Faith comprehends as fact what cannot be experienced by the physical senses. Please pay attention to this statement. Faith comprehends as fact what cannot be experienced by the physical senses. The physical world in which we live is a sense world. It is a world that is controlled and shaped by our senses. Anything that makes sense in the physical world, it has to speak or to be shaped or controlled by our senses. Hear me. In the physical world, if I can see it, then it is real. In the physical world, if I can hear it, then it is real. If I can smell it, if I can taste it, if I can touch it, then it is real. In the physical realm where we live, anything that appeals to our five senses, that is what is real. But in the realm where God lives, things operate differently. The principle in the spiritual realm is that if I can believe it, then it is real. In the physical world, we have to see it, we have to hear it, we have to touch it, taste it, smell it. But in the spiritual realm, we have to believe it. 2 Corinthians 5, verse 7, the Bible says, "For we walk by faith and not by sight." Powerful verse. The Bible says, "For we walk by faith and not by sight." So the just shall live by faith. What does it mean? It means the just shall not live by sight, but they shall live by what they believe. The just shall not live by what they hear, but they shall live by what they believe. The just shall not live by what they feel, but they shall live by what they believe. The just shall not live by what they smell, but by what they believe. So faith, according to the word of God, it believes what God says in the Bible. You must continue believing God, even if Satan speaks to the contrary. You must continue to believe God, even if the devil tells you that you have overstayed your welcome, you have reached your expiry date, you are beyond repair. Let me go, take you right now to John chapter 11. I'm going to read from verse number 38 to verse number 14. John 11 from verse number 38 to verse number 14. This is the story of Lazarus when Jesus raised Lazarus from the dead. Then Jesus, again groaning in himself, came to the tomb. That was the tomb of Lazarus. It was a cave, and a stone lay against it. Jesus said, "Take away the stone. Take away the stone." Martha, the sister of him who was dead, said to him, "Lord, by this time there is a stench, for he has been dead 4 days." She says, "Jesus, I understand you say I must take away the stone, but let me say this to you, that this guy has been dead 4 days. He is smelling as we speak. There is a stench." And Jesus said to him, "Did I not say to you that if you would believe, you would see the glory of God? If you would believe, you will see the glory of God. If you would believe what the Bible tells you, you will see the glory of God." It is never too late for God to intervene in your case. It is never too late for God to intervene in your marriage, in your family, in your career, in your business, in your ministry. It is never too late for God to intervene in our country. It is never too late for you to experience the power of God and the glory of God. Jesus says, "If only you would believe, you will see my glory. You will see my power. You will see my presence working in your life." Hear me, child of God. It is never too late for you to experience your breakthrough. I don't care how your situation or how your case smells right now. I am here to declare to you that your due time for a miracle has come in the name of Jesus. If you read earlier in the chapter, Mary and Martha, the sisters of Lazarus, said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother or our brother would not have died." So when Jesus showed up, they said, "Jesus, if you came earlier, our brother would be alive today." You can tell that somehow they were saying, "Jesus, we know you have the power to perform miracles, but is this the right time? If you came earlier, our brother would be alive." I want you to understand, child of God, that God's miracles, God's power, God's glory cannot be constrained by the limitations of time. God works for you, in you, through you, any time. So, meaning you can't say to God, God, I expected you to perform this miracle the first day I prayed, or within a week, or within a month, or within a year. You need to understand that God can perform a miracle anytime in your life. He is never too late to show up and to answer your prayers and to give you your breakthrough. The story of Abraham and Sarah in the Bible is very interesting, but also encouraging for us. God gave them a promise, but it took 25 years for them to hold the promise in their hands. Hear me, child of God. It took 25 years for Abraham and Sarah to hold their Isaac in their hands. But what I like about the story of Abraham, Sarah, and Isaac is that the promise that they received from God after 25 years in the physical, to this day, that promise is great. That promise is successful. That promise still has an impact to this day. You see, the problem we have in the church today is that people don't want to wait on the Lord and continue to hold on to their faith regardless of the circumstances around them. That's the problem that we have. People don't want to wait on the Lord. They want to receive it now and enjoy it now and experience it now. When you say to them, keep praying, keep believing, keep trusting God, they just look at you. I want to say to you, God is never late to give you your miracle, your breakthrough, but you have to learn to wait upon the Lord. These days, people are looking for quick answers, instant miracles, immediate breakthroughs. If they don't see it within a week, they are off to another church. And most of the people that are manipulated these days and abused these days spiritually are those that are looking for instant miracles, people who don't want to wait upon the Lord. Let me help you on how the kingdom of God operates, or how the world of the spirit operates. Let's go to Genesis 8, verse number 22. Powerful verse. Genesis 8, verse number 22. The Bible says, while the earth remains, seed time and harvest, cold and heat, winter and summer, day and night shall not cease. While the earth remains, seed time and harvest, cold and heat, winter and summer, day and night shall not cease. Meaning life is about seasons, but God is greater than the seasons. Let me say it again. Life is about seasons, but God is greater than the seasons. God is God in every season. God does not change. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. God is God in every season. Seed time and harvest. Seed time and harvest. People these days, they want to reap without sowing. If you think you're going to enjoy harvest without sowing a seed, you are daydreaming. This is not how things work in the kingdom of God. You need to acknowledge that there is seed time and harvest. You need to acknowledge that life is about seasons. You need to acknowledge that faith must work in every season that you find yourself in. Hear me, child of God. Cold and heat. Hear me. Cold is not evil. It is good and necessary as heat in developing a complete person in you. The Bible says, as long as the earth remains, there will be cold and heat. But I want you to understand, in exercising your faith, that cold not evil. It is as good and necessary as heat in developing a complete person in you. Winter is not evil. It is as good and necessary as summer in developing a champion in you. For you to be a champion, you must experience all the seasons combined working in your life are what make you a champion, an achiever, and a successful person. Night is not evil. It is as good and necessary as day in raising a leader in you. Hear me, child of God. Challenges, storms, persecutions, trials, failures, and losses are part of the package for success. Let me say this again. Challenges that you face in your life, storms that you go through, persecutions, trials, failures, and losses, all combined are part of the package for success. Hear me. Faith does not mean that you will not face storms, but it means that you will conquer your storms. Faith does not mean that you will not go through challenges. It means you will overcome every challenge that you face by faith. Hear me. If it is night in South Africa, we don't run away to a continent where it is day. Life does not work like that. We go through the night by faith, believing that sooner than we think, the light will shine on us too. Hear me, child of God. When you go through your night season, there is nothing wrong with you. There is nothing wrong with your marriage, your family, your career, your ministry, your business. It's just night in your life. You must go through your night by faith. Don't run away from your challenges. Hear me, child of God. If it is winter in South Africa, we don't relocate to Europe to experience summer. Life does not work like that. We go through the winter season by faith, believing that we serve a God who is the same in winter and the same in summer. The God that we serve, he does not change. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Hear me, child of God. You cannot be running away from challenges. You must face your challenges by faith. This message that I'm presenting to you, it says to you, life is about challenges, but you need to stand on your faith in all the seasons that you experience. In season and out of season, you must walk by faith. When things are working in your favor or working against you, you must walk by faith. In winter, in summer, you walk by faith. Day and night, you walk by faith. During the seed time and the harvest time, you walk by faith. Hear me. Let's go to Isaiah 43, verses 1 and 2. I want you to understand something here. It reads, "But now, thus says the Lord, who created you, O Jacob, and he who formed you, O Israel, fear not." God is saying to you, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. You are mine. In other words, you belong to me. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. God says, fear not. When you go through challenges, he will be with you. So during challenges, a season of storms in your life, faith says, I still believe that God is with me. I still believe that God promised that he will not leave me nor forsake me. My relationship with God is based on the word of God. When I challenges, I check what the word of God says about my situation. I check the promises of God regarding my situation in season and out of season. I continue to believe God. So he says, when you go or when you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, nor shall the flame scorch you. When you go through the fire, you shall not be burned, nor shall the flame scorch you. So God says, you are mine. I watch over you day and night. I am with you in every season of your life. When you go through challenges, continue to stand on your faith. The just shall live by faith in season and out of season. The Apostle Paul was a man of great faith. I want to believe we all agree. Yet in Romans 8, from verse number 35 to verse number 37, he says, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? So Apostle Paul here mentions challenges in his own life. Here is a man of God who walked with God, who had an encounter with Jesus. And yet he says, I still experience challenges in my life. But my concept of God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. How I relate with God does not change regardless of what I face in life, in season and out of season. I stand on the word of God. That is why he says, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Tribulations, distress, persecutions, famine, nakedness, peril, or sword will not be able to separate us from the love of Christ. As it is written, for your sake, we are killed all day long. Meaning your ministry will be challenged. Your marriage will be challenged. Your family will face storms and persecutions. Your business will be tried and tested. But you must know that God is with you. He promised in his word that he will never leave you nor forsake you. Paul says, yet in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. What a revelation. That in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. This is how you exercise your faith. When you are faced with a challenge, you say, in this challenge, the word of God says, I am more than a conqueror. In this storm, the Bible promised me that God will never leave me nor forsake me. God said he will be with me until the end of the age. Hear me, child of God. We don't run away from challenges. We stand our ground in faith. Having faith in God does not mean you will not face challenges. It means by faith, you will overcome all your challenges. The just shall live by faith in season and out of season. The just shall live by faith in seed time and harvest. The just shall live by faith day and night. The just shall live by faith summer and winter. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. In part two of this message, I requested you to pay particular attention to certain words in this verse. Now, substance, things, hope, evidence. I've already spoken to you on the word now. We said to you, faith operates now. Faith asks from God now. It receives by faith now. And it celebrates that breakthrough, that miracle now. Faith says, if God said it, I believe it, and it is as God said it. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of what we do not see. Today I want us to talk on the word substance, because the Bible says now faith is the substance of things hoped for. So what is substance? Substance is a material with physical characteristics. This is the dictionary definition of substance. Substance is a material with physical characteristics. Substance is something that you can touch. Substance is something that you can see, hear, taste, smell, and touch. You remember when I started, I said the physical realm where we live is controlled by our senses. So substance is what appeals to your senses. Substance is what agrees with your senses. Substance is something that you can eat, drink, wear, drive. Substance is something that you can touch. Now, it is not in the sweet by and by. It is something that you experience now. It is something that you enjoy now. Substance is with you right here in the physical realm. Hear me. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for. It means that faith is able to take what is in the realm of the spirit, what you may not see, touch, taste, smell, and experience physically. But by faith, you are able to bring it from the realm of the spirit into the realm of the physical where you are right now. Hear me, child of God. Faith is very powerful. It is a spiritual force that is able to translate spiritual blessings and bring them into the physical world where you live. Faith is the spiritual force of God that makes the impossible possible. Why? Faith makes the impossible possible. Faith is that spiritual force that makes God to be God. So if you want God to be God in your life, you need faith. If you want God to be God in your marriage, in your family, you need faith. If you want God to be God in your career, in your business, you need faith. Faith, hear me. Faith is that spiritual power or force that takes a spiritual God and makes him part of your life in the physical realm where you are. Faith is that power that translates spiritual blessings into physical, tangible blessings that you can enjoy in the physical realm where you are right now. The just shall live by faith. Ephesians 1 verse 3. The Bible says, blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ. God, the Bible tells us, he has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in heavenly places in Christ. Meaning that the blessings of God are in the realm of the spirit. The blessings of God are in the realm of the spirit. They are spiritual. They are in Christ. So it is important for you to understand this, that the blessings of God that have already been given to us by God, they are spiritual, number one. Number two, they are in the realm of the spirit. Number three, they are in Christ. Who is Christ? Christ is the Word of God. Again, John chapter 1, from verse number 1 to verse number 4. The Bible says, in the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God. The Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. And nothing was made which was not made through Him. And in Him, the Word was life. And the life was the light of men. The light shines in darkness. And the darkness cannot comprehend the power of the light. And the Word here is Jesus Christ. Meaning that the blessings which are spiritual and are in the realm of the Spirit can only be experienced in the realm where we are through the power of the Word of God. So the faith that I'm teaching you is the faith of God, faith according to the Word of God, and faith that is built upon the Word of God. Hear me, child of God. God has already blessed us. We are not looking for blessings. Blessings have already been, issued or given to us by God. What you need to master or to know as a believer is how to access the blessings, how to attract the blessings, how to receive the blessings. Blessings are already given to you by God. But if you don't know how to access the blessings, how to attract spiritual blessings into the physical realm where you are, and how to receive, is one thing for something to be given to you. But if you don't know how to receive it, you may not enjoy it. Hear me, child of God. It's important for us to understand that blessings are already given to us by God, but we receive them by faith. So it is very important for you to understand this. If you miss this one, then you will be a victim of manipulation and abuse, because you will be running around looking for something that God has already given to you. You will be running around looking for healing when God has given you healing, and all you need to do is to receive healing by faith. You will be running around looking for prosperity instead of receiving prosperity by faith. It is important for you to understand this, that blessings have already been given to you. Healing has already been given to you, because the Bible tells us that by the stripes of Jesus you were healed. And if you were healed, it means you are healed. 1 Peter 2:24, the Bible guarantees healing for you. But also in Psalms 107:20, the Bible tells us that God sent His word and He healed us and it delivered us from destruction. Meaning you are already healed. You are already delivered. All you need to do is to attract your healing, is to receive your healing by faith. But if you don't know this, you'll be running around looking for something that God has already given to you. So the Bible says regarding prosperity in 3 John 2 that God wishes above all else that you may prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prospers, meaning that prosperity has already been given to you, but you must know how to receive it by faith. Knowledge of the Word of God is very important for you as a believer. That is why I want to encourage you to study the Word of God. Study your Bible. Read your Bible. That's the only way you can have the faith according to the Word of God. The people who know their God shall be strong and do exploits. The Bible says you shall know the truth, and the truth will set you free. And the truth is Jesus Christ. If you know the Word of God, if you know truth in the Bible and the promises of God, you will enjoy a life of freedom. So that's what the Bible teaches here. That faith is the substance, or now faith is the substance of things hoped for. Let me quickly take you to Luke chapter 1, verse number 37. The Bible says, for with God, nothing will be impossible. For with God, nothing will be impossible. But let me read from verse number 26. Same chapter, Luke 1, from verse number 26 as I close. Now in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And having come in, the angel said to her, rejoice, highly favored one, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women. But when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying and considered what manner of greeting this was. Then the angel said to her, do not be afraid. That's where you start. You must deal with fear. Do not be afraid. God does not operate where there is fear. The word of God does not operate where there is fear. I told you that fear attracts the power of the devil and faith attracts the power of God. He says, do not fear, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bring forth the son and shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. And he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end. Then Mary said to the angel, how can this be, since I do not know a man? She was saying, I hear your message, but this is unheard of. In the physical realm where I live, things don't work like this. They don't operate like this. This is not inconsistent with the laws of biology, life science, and human conception. Where I live in the physical realm, people don't conceive babies the way you say to me now. This is impossible. How can this be, since I do not know a man? Let me prophesy over your life right now. God is about to do in your life what is unheard of. God is about to do in your marriage, in your family, in your business what is unheard of. God is about to give you a miracle, a breakthrough, which your mind will not be able to understand. God is about to perform a miracle in your life. God is about to defy some physical laws and protocols to give you your breakthrough right now in the name of Jesus. God is about to heal you. God is about to deliver you. God is about to save your business. Maybe you thought by the end of this lockdown, it will be over with your business. But I've come to tell you that God is about to deliver and save and rescue your business right now. In the name of Jesus, God is about to do for you what is unheard of. Then Mary said to the angel, how can this be, since I do not know a man? And the angel answered and said to her, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Highest will overshadow you. Therefore also, that Holy One who is to be born will be called the Son of God. The Holy Spirit will come upon you. The Holy Spirit, the power of God, will overshadow you. Wow! What happened in Genesis 1 is about to happen in your life right now. The same way God created in Genesis 1 is about to create something powerful for you right now. Something that has not been heard of. Because if you read Genesis 1 verses 2 and 3, the Bible says the earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep. Maybe this is your situation right now in your life, in your marriage, in your business, in your family, in the lives of your children. There is voidness, emptiness, darkness. Things are not working for you. But I've come to declare that in the same way that God created in Genesis 1, he's creating something powerful for you right now. The Bible says in that situation, the Holy Spirit was hovering over the face of the waters, and God said, let there be light. And there was light. And the angel said, now indeed Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is now the sixth month, for her was called barren. For with God, nothing will be impossible. With God, hear me, child of God, nothing will be impossible. With God, what man cannot do, with God, it is possible. God says to you right now, what you have been praying for, you receive it right now. Maybe things were working against you, but God is saying yes to your prayers, yes to your faith, yes to everything that you're believing him for right now in the name of Jesus. Remember that he is omnipotent, omnipresent, omniscient. He has all the power. He is unlimited. He is everywhere. He has all the knowledge. May you receive your breakthrough right now. In the name of Jesus, I declare healing upon you. Whatever sickness that you're suffering from right now, as I stretch my hand towards you, receive your healing in the name of Jesus. Receive your breakthrough right now in the name of Jesus. Receive your miracle right now in the name of Jesus. Remember that the just shall live by faith. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. For he who comes to him must believe that he is, and that he is the rewarder of those that diligently seek after him. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of what we do not see. So I challenge you right now to walk by faith and to build your life on the foundation of the word of God. God bless you. This is Apostle M.B. Jinipoko, making you brighter, better, and bigger. Let me pray with all the people that are saying, Apostle, today I want to give my life to Jesus. I want my sins to be forgiven. I want to be a child of God. Please make this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, with my mouth, I confess that you are Lord. With my heart, I believe that you are raised from the dead. Today, I give you my life. Forgive me, Lord, and wash me with your blood. In the name of Jesus. If you have prayed this prayer right now, you are born again, you are a child of God, welcome into the family of God. God bless you. Remember that God is good. I cover you with the blood of Jesus. I pronounce peace upon you, protection, prosperity, perfect health, the power of God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for listening and joining us. What a powerful anointed message.
Amen.
The just shall live by faith. Continue downloading the single that Apostle released, Sithembela ukho igama. We trust your name. This is the song by which we defeat the COVID-19. We trust in the name of the Lord. Download it. It's available on all the music channels. May God bless you.
Amen.